A local artist of Medicine Hat, Alberta, does these large murals here. I had the pleasure of talking with Kari, artist named Kari Kanvas, spelled K-A-R-I-K-A-N-V-A-S. I'll leave a link to her Facebook and her Instagram at the end of the interview. She doesn't have a YouTube channel.
Hello, my name is Kari. My art name is Kari Kanvas.
Kari Kanvas.
Yes, with a K, both with K.
Okay. Yeah. How long have you been doing art?
Pretty much steadily since probably about 2009,
oh,
maybe
wow.
2010.
Did you take any courses or classes or?
Yeah, in high school, that's pretty much it. I took like all the upgrading classes. I never went, but I did take them or parts of them.
Yeah.
And then no, I didn't. It wasn't until I moved out of Saskatchewan to Alberta that I started really painting.
So if you're like me, like if you're into art, you can tell by how you do your pictures that you know color, you know how to place objects.
Yeah, I kind of learn as I go, but I had a really, really good art teacher. And a lot of my siblings are all like either graphic designers or in arts of some kind, so it kind of runs in the family.
Okay.
But yeah, so I definitely learned and had a lot of trial and error.
Yeah, yeah. So I'm just going to go over some of the pictures you got here again.
Hey, if there's anyone out there that's interested in her art, please donate or purchase one of her prints or buy an original canvas piece. I love her style of art. She has a lot going on in her art. So I thought my YouTube friends should see this. Thanks, Kari, for sharing your work, not only with us, but to the rest of the world. Thank you, Kari, for sharing the stories your art otherwise might not have had a voice.
And they're all local artists in there?
Yeah. Well, not all. Like, we brought in an artist from, like, there's Australia, Toronto, California, Calgary. So artists have come kind of all over.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. So really lucky. Even, like, on the front of the Cineboy building, like, that's one of, like, a huge street artist. His name is Bacon, and he did a huge piece on there, the girl's face. And then a bunch of kind of, like, really pretty graffiti writing.
Yeah.
But yeah, so we're lucky. We've got some
well,
really
I see
good
some
here.
Probably just street artists. They do graffiti over top of everything else.
Yeah.
And they think they're artists.
Yeah. Yeah, we've been pretty lucky. Most of our pieces that we've done kind of with the public haven't really been touched.
Okay.
So it's good.
Do you sign your work when you do that?
Yeah, I usually do kind of in the bottom right corner. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and then we also had two other kind of stand-up wooden murals, but I don't know where they went. They used to be right by the Dairy Queen.
Okay, yeah, down here by the Dairy Queen.
Yeah, at the other pop-up park, but I don't know where they ended up. So.
What are your price ranges for your art?
So these are just prints of the canvases I've done, but so prints I'm doing for $30, and then for an actual canvas, it kind of ranges anywhere from probably about $150 and then up.
How big is the canvas?
The standard I start with is 16 by 20, and
okay.
Then I'll go all the way up. But I do a lot of like little intricate details in there.
And
almost like all of my paintings have actual crystals somewhere in there, like on the actual canvases.
What is it, like oil or pastels or?
It's acrylic.
Acrylic.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's what this.
What do you mean by you revamped it? Did you redo the whole painting?
Yeah. Well, kind of. I kind of picture what it used to look like. Because it was the first mural I'd ever done, and I just was never really happy with it. It always felt very incomplete to me, and I always felt like I could have done better.
Okay.
And then, so I finally got the chance to come in here and clean it up a little bit.
I hope you have my channel name.
Yeah,
or something,
I do, yeah.
Because next week. Oh, did you?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, good,
yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll have to put that up next week. I'm going to do a more video of all the.
Yeah, for sure.
I think I'll just put, because I'm doing a proper interview. I'll do like just your stuff in one and do the rest of downtown art in another video or something.
Thank you very much.
So what drew you to, like, I see mostly skeleton and skull and that kind of. Is that what draws you to the to like?
Yeah, it just, I don't know how or why it started. I think it just because I always wanted to kind of draw like the Day of the Dead kind of style. It always kind of resonated with me.
Okay.
And then kind of as the last few years have gone on, a lot of my stuff has been for overdose awareness, actually, which is why I have a lot of purples in my pieces, is because it represents overdose awareness.
Oh, right on. Because it's like you're bringing the skull and the skeleton to life.
Yeah, and so it's kind of what I like to show is kind of like the life and the death and bringing them together to show like the beautiful things. And like most of my pieces have butterflies in them as well.
Yeah.
And for me, that represents like transition and changes.
Like the one in the subway, that's a really nice one.
Yeah.
I like that.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, so everything in them always kind of means something.
But I mean, there's so much in them that...
Yeah, I put a lot of little details in them.
Yeah.
And like I said, every single actual canvas has like a crystal somewhere in it.
What do you mean by crystal?
Like something kind of like this.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, like healing crystals.
Oh.
Yeah, so it's hard to tell in the actual prints, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, so kind of like to combine like the two different mediums.
Okay, wow.
Yeah.
Oh, simply amazing.
Thank you. And I appreciate you coming down too and taking the time to do that. That's awesome.
Yeah. So maybe I'll do kind of a shout out online and maybe I can send some people your way or something.
Awesome. Yeah, that'd be great.
How do people get a hold of you if you're not here all the time?
So I usually use either Instagram or Facebook. I do have business cards in the works, but they're not made yet.
Okay.
So for me, it's
so your artist name. They can find you through that on Instagram and Facebook and stuff like that.
Yeah, and it's Kari with a K, so Kari, and then Kanvas, Kanvas.
Okay. Yeah. K-A-N, both with a K.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'll steer people that way.
Oh, awesome.
Well, again, it was nice to meet you, and thanks for the interview.
Yeah, thank you so much.
And keep your eyes and ears posted for it'll come out next week.
Yeah, I will for sure. Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, thank you.
And let me know what you think.
Yeah, I will for sure.
I hope I do a good job.
Oh, I'm sure you will. The first one is awesome. It's so cool to see that. Yeah, it's just neat. It's nice to see when people actually appreciate your art and will take the time to video it or photograph it. It's nice.
Yeah.
Feeling.
Great.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming down.
Yes. I'm